Good morning, and welcome to today's edition of Stephen Whiteside's Stock Market Timing Television. Each day at this time, Stephen takes a technical look at the markets, including the S&P 500, NASDAQ, gold, crude oil, as well as the most widely held leveraged ETFs. This video is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit TheUptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's video newsletter.
Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Thursday, October 7th, 2010. In the pre-market on Thursday morning at 7:30 a.m., we've got stock index futures basically unchanged. So not a lot of volatility in the futures in the pre-market. There are some employment numbers coming out at 8:30 this morning that could add some volatility to the market on Thursday morning. Now, Wednesday was essentially a very quiet day. It was an inside day for the S&P 500, so a lot of people are going to bracket the previous day's range and look to buy on the breakout or sell on the breakdown of Tuesday's range. We need a daily close below 1135.46 on Thursday to give us a new sell signal. For the Dow, we traded a little higher than Tuesday's range yesterday. For the Dow, we need a close below 10,734. The Dow is up at our next price target, which is 10,937, and we've got the S&P 500 at its next price target at 1156.25. Now, we traded above it the last 2 days, but we haven't broken free of the 1156.25 area. We traded through that yesterday, so it's still acting as a magnet, and we're looking for either a breakout or a breakdown from this point. Now, the VIX is below the lower channel line, so it's still on a sell signal, and it being on a sell signal, of course, is supportive for higher stock prices. A close above 23.46 is the first sign that that's about to change. Bank stocks, second day of a buy signal, really didn't go anywhere yesterday. We've got that resistance at 131.25, a breakdown below 125.91 on Thursday would give us a new sell signal. For the NASDAQ 100, we're still on a buy signal. We traded lower yesterday. Don't have a lot of enthusiasm for this buy signal, but you got to manage your money. So we're looking for a close below 1981.21 on Thursday to give us a new sell signal. We'll cover the NASDAQ more on Friday in the Qtrends newsletter. Looking at semiconductors, we're looking for a close below 340.39. For gold stocks, had another good day yesterday. We're looking for a close below 195.68. Some of the other indexes are proprietary indexes. We've got Cramer's Mobile Internet Index. We're looking for a close below 64.68. We're really not seeing a lot of sector rotation at the moment. Most sectors are doing fairly well. We've got credit card stocks doing well. And our uptrend weight loss index is also doing very well at the present time. Take a look at the GLD. It was up again yesterday. It's up again in the pre-market on Thursday morning. We need a close below 127.27 on Thursday to give us a sell signal. For the SLV, we need a close below 21.13. There is a copper ETF, but it's thinly traded, so I don't have it in my database. Maybe next year. But right now, we're still playing the futures, and we need to close below 365 on Thursday to give us a new sell signal for copper. Bonds are up testing the previous high. We need to close below 132.49 on Thursday to give us a sell signal. Crude oil is up testing the previous high. 79.20 would give us a sell signal on Thursday. And natural gas is getting pretty close to a buy signal. A close above 390 on Thursday would do that. For the U.S. dollar, made a new low for this move yesterday. The euro made a new high. The euro is not the only thing going up at the present time. We've got the Australian dollar, British pound. Japanese yen is back to where it was just before the government intervened a few weeks ago. We've got the New Zealand dollar and the Swiss franc all doing very well. So it's not just the U.S. dollar and the euro. It's the U.S. dollar and everything else. Taking a look at 60-minute charts for Thursday's trading activity, we could remain bullish on the market as long as it continues to trade above 1140. Below 1140, we have the bears back in control. Our first sign of weakness would be an hourly close below 1155.65 on Thursday. For the VIX, we're looking for the VIX to trade below 23. As long as it stays below 23, we can be bullish on the stock market. Above 23, we can be bearish. The first sign that things are going to change is an hourly close above 22.05 on Thursday. For bank stocks, we're looking for an hourly close below 129.62. For the NASDAQ 100, we're looking for a close above 2011 to get us back on the positive side of the 60-minute charts. For the SOX index, we're looking for an hourly close above 347.08 to give us a buy signal on Thursday. And for gold stocks, we're looking for a close on the XAU below 204.37 on an hourly basis to generate a new intraday sell signal. Okay, that's all for me for this week, folks. On Friday, we'll be doing some of our sector presentations for gold, fertilizer, and the Qs. So the next time you'll see Stock Market Timing Television is next Monday. So if I don't talk to you between now and then, have a great day, have a great weekend, and we'll talk to you again on Monday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.